hello and welcome to the National Training Complex in Cary, North Carolina. I'm Joe DiRienzo alongside Editor-in-Chief of Baseball America, John Manuel. And we're here today to announce the 16 teams who will be competing in the 2017 National High School Invitational. And John, it's one of my favorite parts of the year. It's an awesome event to see 16 teams from across the country come here. I always make sure I circle it on my calendar. I know I'm not the only one.
Yeah, definitely. We at Baseball America, you know, we're right up the road up Highway 55, and this is always a hallmark of the calendar for us on the amateur side, and looking forward to the draft, but also just the high school top 25 rankings we do, the player rankings that we do. It all comes together at the NHSI, and you see this in other sports. You see this at the college level. You see tournaments, but to see it in the high school level, and I also should compliment you guys on the work you guys have done and taking an idea and making it a reality. And every year the tournament seems like it gets a little bit better and a little bit better. And you know, we've seen highlights from Courtney Hawkins here doing backflips and as a precursor to what he did on the draft show, or the dog piles that you see from the First Academy from Florida, or the teams from California coming back here and winning their championships. I just love seeing the talent that comes through every year. I love seeing kind of the pageantry of the teams and how much it matters to them and use it as a measuring stick. So it's a great event, not just for high school baseball, not just for USA Baseball, but for the whole baseball community.
And it keeps building on itself every year. We've got a great crop of talent coming in 2017. We'll kick things off and see our first group of teams who will be coming to Cary for the 2017 NHSI.
From Plantation, Florida, American Heritage. From Southwest Ranches, Florida, Archbishop McCarthy. And from Arlington, Tennessee, Arlington High School.
There are our first three teams. Archbishop McCarthy head coach Rich Bielski has won six Florida state championships dating back to 2010, and he brings an experienced group of players who have won back-to-back Florida state championships.
That experience really is invaluable. You know, we've played several top-ranked teams on the way to those state championships, and getting into play in, you know, the spring training home of the Boston Red Sox. It's a big league field, it's a big league stadium. You know, all those experiences really prepare you for what's ahead, and we're hoping those prepare us as well for this national tournament. You know, all the teams we've spoken to that are from Florida and gone to this tournament, they come back raving about, you know, the quality of the teams. And again, we're looking forward to the challenge. I'm sure we're going to run into many good teams, and we're going to do everything we can to prepare and get ready for that.
These are just three of the teams competing in the 2017 NHSI, but John, each of these teams brings some intrigue to the table.
Yeah, I think the obvious names are the South Florida teams, Archbishop McCarthy and American Heritage. You know, these are teams that have won state championships, produced first-round picks, and future big leaguers. I'm looking forward to seeing Tristan Cassis out of American Heritage. This kid's a mammoth player. We saw how he performed for the 18U team in the Pan Am Championships. Two of the six home runs in the tournament hit by Cassis, and he was one of the youngest players the entire event. So big power at first base, big arm strength. We might get to see him pitch as well. I mean, this is just a really intriguing player for future draft prospects. And then Arlington out of Tennessee, Arlington's seeking to come here and make their name. Archbishop McCarthy's already made its name nationally. Same thing with American Heritage. So that's a really intriguing start to the tournament.
Yeah, and we're just getting things started here. Here's your next group of NHSI teams competing in 2017.
From Chicago, Illinois, Brother Rice High School. From Fort Myers, Florida, Canterbury School. From Coleman, Alabama, Coleman High School. From Dana Point, California, Dana Hills High School. And from Chandler, Arizona, Hamilton High School.
Hamilton High School will be making a return trip to Cary after participating in the 2013 NHSI, and we have a first-time representative out of the Midwest with Brother Rice High School out of Chicago. Head coach John McCarthy appreciates that honor, and he knows it's not lost on his team.
First off, truly humbled by the invitation, and then next, totally excited for the opportunity to play the very best in the country. I mean, the experience allows our program to hopefully one day become one of the elite programs in the country, and very grateful to be picked, you know, from all the great teams in Illinois, and very hungry to represent Illinois in a positive way and show the quality of baseball we have here in the Chicago and Illinois state. But we're thankful to USA Baseball, and we're thankful for USA Baseball showcasing high school baseball and showcasing the greatness in our student athletes.
We mentioned some top prospects were coming to Cary this year. Here's two of them. Hans Kraus coming with Dana Hills High School and Jacob Heatherly coming with Coleman out of Alabama.
You know, we had Braxton Garrett here last year, top left-hander in the draft last year out of Alabama and pitched to the NHSI. And Jacob Heatherly here is going to try to redo that and kind of reprise that role. And Hans Kraus has experience in this stadium making the U.S. national team. And what better experience can a high school kid get than either pitching here or then pitching for his country, wearing USA on his chest like Hans Kraus did, and helping win a gold medal as he did starting in the gold medal game for the 18U team. So those guys match up. That's going to be one that, you know, we had a couple of years ago, the game on the backfield where every team scouted with the Jacob Gatewood from Clovis against Michael Geddes from down in Georgia, and every team was represented. You could have that kind of scene here. Anywhere Hans Kraus goes, scouts are sure to follow. Same thing with Jacob Heatherly. So I'm really looking forward to individually those two pitchers, or if they happen to match up in the NHSI.
Absolutely. And we're at the halfway point here in our team reveal for the 2017 NHSI. Let's keep things going and see our next group of teams. From Cornelius, North Carolina, Huff High School. From Huntington Beach, California, Huntington Beach High School. From Malvern, Pennsylvania, Malvern Prep. And from Merritt Island, Florida, Merritt Island High School. Huff High School will be the host school for the 2017 NHSI coming from the Greater Charlotte area, and the 2016 NHSI champion Huntington Beach will return to defend their title. Head coach Benji Madure knows that that puts a bit of a target on the team's back, but he says his team is ready to defend their championship.
I think we do have to make our kids aware of, I remember last year going and seeing all of the billboards of the defending champions, you know, the Walk of Honor where it has all of the champions over the last 6 years, and our name's going to be on there and we're going to be there. And I remember thinking, you know, seeing Modern Day and the First Academy on that list, and I remember thinking, oh man, I want to play those guys. And I'm going to make sure that our guys know that yes, there will be a target on us and people are going to come after us, and we can't change our approach in any way, shape, or form. We're going to play hard, we're going to play with our hair on fire, and just do what we do, and we'll take whatever the result is. You know, we're not going to try to do anything extra, and I think that's the whole key to every single game that we play there.
Huntington Beach will be returning for a third consecutive NHSI appearance, trying to defend that NHSI championship. John, how rare is it for a team to come back and be so high up in the national ranks to be able to come to the NHSI 3 years in a row?
We've seen teams come back here, but not three times in a row. And this tournament has some history, but so does this group of players at Huntington Beach. I mean, this group of players, a lot of them go back to their little league days playing together, and they had a lot of success as little leaguers. They've had success at the high school level, and they've had success at the national team level. Nick Prado has three gold medals, 15U, two of the 18U team. Hagen Danner was with him on this last team. He has two gold medals. So this team has done it here in Cary. They've done it there in California. You know, they're at the top rung, and you know, someone's have to knock them down. And maybe it'll be a team from North Carolina like Huff. I mean, I'm a North Carolinian, if you can't hear it in my accent. I'd love to see a North Carolina team come to NHSI and show out. So rep and present for the Tar Heel State, Huff High. We're looking for you.
Yeah, we're looking forward to seeing how Huff represents as the host school. There's four more teams left to see who they'll be facing off against in the 2017 NHSI field. Let's see who they are.
From Orange, California, Orange Lutheran High School. From Fort Collins, Colorado, Rocky Mountain High School. From West Covina, California, South Hills High School. And from Winder, Georgia, Winder Barrow High School.
And there are the final group of the 16 teams who will be competing in the 2017 National High School Invitational. Once again, we have an incredibly deep talent pool of players, 10 of the Baseball America High School 100, and over 80 Division I recruits. And this field is rounded out, John, by a pair of returners.
Yeah, I think talent gets you here and gets you in the discussion to come to the NHSI and gets you in the discussion to win it. But experience helps, too. And Orange Lutheran has been here before in 2014. I remember seeing them back there on field three. And it was a game where they were already eliminated from championship contention. But the way they played, how hard they played, how skillfully they played, it was a well-run program. It wasn't a team, it was a program. And Coach Scott Bullock at Rocky Mountain has the same thing going in Colorado. those players come in here with a chip on their shoulder to show that Colorado baseball can contend with California baseball or anywhere around the country. So
absolutely, and we're really looking forward to an exciting 2017 event with a group of returning schools, along with some newcomers, and obviously, as always, an incredible, deep group of talented prospects. For John Manuel, I'm Joe DiRienzo. Thank you all very much for tuning in. Stay tuned in the coming weeks leading up to the National High School Invitational as we reveal the matchups in the first round.